Welcome to Engineer on Python. This is a Python programming course for engineers. In this video, I will talk about Python inputs, outputs, and assignment statements. Let's first see some output statements. Each print is an output statement. It prints the information on a separate line. If the information is a string closed with a pair of double quotation marks or single quotation marks, it will show the exact information as output. If it is a math operation like 3 plus 4, it will show the calculation results, which is 7. A bare print will print a blank line, like this one. Multiple outputs should be separated by commas. We try to print these two numbers, 3 and 4. Separate them with a comma, and this printed result is separated by a space. We can connect the strings and the math operation with a comma. The calculation result will be automatically put behind the string, like this. There is a space between is and 7. If you forget to use a comma, you will see an error, because this is not the correct Python syntax. Similarly, this is also wrong because we don't have a comma. A simple assignment like x equals 4 means we are assigning a value 4 to a variable named x. Variables can be reassigned many times. For example, we can change the value to 5 and later change it by increasing 1 to itself, so we get 6. You cannot try to use a variable without a value assigned to it. In this example, we try to print the value of y. However, we haven't assigned any value to y yet. We will see an error. Now let's talk about how to get the keyboard input from a user. What this statement does is it shows a message to the user. Enter your favorite number between 0 and 9. Then it waits for the user to input a number, and it will give this input to a variable named number string. We see this is a string because it is enclosed by a pair of quotation marks. Next, we can use Python to evaluate this number string and give the result to another variable number. As a result, we convert it from a string 4 to a real number 4. We cannot do mathematical operations using a string, but we can do it using a number. That is the difference. Number string plus 3 will give you an error. Number plus 3 will give you the result, which is 7. The two statements can be combined into one. They are equivalent to this statement. This is a more compact way of getting a user's input. Some programmers suggest that using eval is a bad practice in Python programming because it can be dangerous and insecure sometimes. If the user inputted some malicious code, it may compromise your system and steal or damage the data on your computer. You can check it out by following this link. To make it safer, we may use a float function instead of the eval function. The float function will just convert the input to a floating point number. If the input is some malicious code, it will just create an error. We already talked about the simple assignment, but what is simultaneous assignment? It is a unique feature of the Python programming language. Several values can be assigned at the same time. They are matched by position. In this example, we have two variables on the left-hand side, A and B. They are separated by a comma. There are two values on the right-hand side, 1 and 2. They are also separated by a comma. What it does is that it assigns value 1 to variable A and value 2 to variable B simultaneously. We can confirm by printing out their values. This is correct. A is 1 and B is 2. In this example, we calculate the sum, which is A plus B, and assign it to S. And we calculate the difference, which is A minus B, and assign it to D. The result shows the sum is 3, and the difference is negative 1. The following three examples will further demonstrate the benefits of using simultaneous assignment. Suppose we have two variables A and B. A equals 1 and B equals 2. We want to swap the values of A and B. this is our first try. We directly give B to A and then A to B. After we print them out, however, we find A and B are both equal to 2. What happened? It turns out when we give B to A, its value is changed to 2. Then we give A to B, B's value will still be 2. So that's why we have the same value for A and B. This is the wrong way to swap the value of two variables. Now let's try it in another way. Still, A is 1 and B is 2. We introduce a temporary variable named temp. We give A's value to temp, so temp's value is 1. Then we give B's value to A, so A's value is 2. Then we give temp's value to B, so B's value will be 1. We have successfully swapped the value of two variables. This is the traditional way of how other programming languages do the swapping. In Python, we can just use one simultaneous assignment statement to do the swapping. On the left-hand side, we have A and B, and on the right-hand side, we have B and A. This method does not have to introduce a temporary variable, and the program is much shorter. What if we want to swap the values of three variables? A is 1, B is 2, and C is 3. Again, we can use a simultaneous assignment to give C's value to A, A's value to B, and B's value to C. As a result, A is 3, B is 1, and C is 2. A simultaneous assignment can be used to get multiple inputs from the user. In this program, we ask the user to enter the numbers of quarters, dimes, nickels, and pennies he has. The user enters 2, 0, 2, and 4. They are given to Q, D, N, and P respectively. Each quarter is 25 cents, each dime is 10 cents, each nickel is 5 cents, and each penny is just 1 cent. Then we use this formula to calculate the total changes the user has. If we want to avoid using the eval function, we can change the code to this. We ask for the numbers of quarters, dimes, nickels, and pennies separately, and convert each one into an integer number. This code is a little bit longer, but it is a safer version. Okay, I just briefly talked about Python inputs, outputs, and assignment statements. The course materials are available on YouTube and GitHub. You can watch the course videos in sequence. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. I'm Yong Wang. Thanks for watching.